What makes the studio in mobility different than a studio in a specific studio in transportation is that we haven't assigned ahead of time a specific subject matter. We have a theme. When we talk about mobility, we're really talking about anything that moves in any scale. So this semester, we're working in human-powered transportation. And within that, there are a variety of concepts. So the idea of wearable transportation is founded on the principle that you don't leave your vehicle or your transport somewhere else. Next semester, we'll be working on designs for the Tappan Zee Bridge. And so the scale is 1,000 times different, one to the other. But the theme of mobility and transport and movement stays intact. And this gives us a way to position studios where students have an idea of the kinds of problems they may be working on.
My role with the Lowline has been mainly design and structural kind of materialization of the whole project. James Ramsey is the owner of Rad Design, an architecture firm in the city. He's a good friend of mine, and he had come to me. He had an idea for this underground space and asked me whether or not I'd be able to help him actualize this idea. The implications for this this concept and these ideas are far-reaching for very dense, urban, populated areas, because a place like New York that has a subterranean infrastructure, it makes so much sense to go underground. So now you see that green spaces are moving to the rooftops. Now we're going to have the chance to have a green space below the surface of New York City. So the dynamic, I think, for urban, dense areas is groundbreaking, is really life-changing, and the tech and the green integration into New York City in this way, I think, can change the history and write a new history, actually, for New York as a whole.